How to calculate projected area, injection molding. What is projected area injection molding? Projected area injection molding is a manufacturing process that involves injecting molten plastic into a mold to produce parts with a specific shape and size. How important to calculate projected area injection molding? Calculating the projected area for injection molding is an important step in the design process for any injection molded parts. This area, also known as the moldable area, is the maximum surface area of the part that will be in contact with the mold cavity during the injection molding process. Accurately calculating this area is essential for determining the size and shape of the injection mold cavity pressure, as well as for estimating the amount of material that will be required for the injection molding process. How to calculate projected area injection molding. This area is typically measured in square millimeters, mm, or square inches, in. To calculate the projected area of a part for injection molding, follow these steps. Obtain a detailed drawing or 3D model of the part being molded. This will typically include the dimensions of each feature of the part, such as its length, width, and height. Identify the direction from which the projected area will be measured. This is typically the direction from which the part will be viewed once it has been molded. Measure the dimensions of the part in the chosen direction. For example, if the part is a rectangular block and the projected area will be measured from the front, the dimensions that should be measured are the length and width of the block. Use the measured dimensions to calculate the projected area of the part. For example, if the part is a rectangular block with dimensions of 10 mm by 20 mm, the projected area would be 10 x 20 is equal to 200 square millimeters. However, this is not the final projected area, as the part will not be flat when it is placed in the mold cavity. To account for the part being curved or angled in the injection mold, the next step is to determine the percentage of the overall surface area that will be in contact with the mold. Use the calculated projected area to determine the amount of plastic that is needed to fill the mold. In general, the projected area should be slightly larger than the volume of the mold to account for any shrinkage that may occur during the injection molding process. It is important to note that the projected area calculation is only an estimate, and the amount of plastic needed may vary depending on the specific details of the molding process. This can be done by visually inspecting the 2D drawing of the part and estimating the percentage of the surface area that will be in contact with the mold. For example, if 50% of the surface area is estimated to be in contact with the mold, the final projected area would be 100 mm, 200 mm x 50%. To ensure the accuracy of the calculation, it is recommended to consult with a field professional or perform a trial run of the molding injection process. In addition to calculating the projected area, other factors must be considered when designing a mold for injection molding tonnage. These include the type and properties of the plastic being used, the size and shape of the mold, and the size injection molding machine tonnage itself. Conclusion: calculating the projected area for injection molding clamp tonnage is an important step in the design process for any injection molded part. By creating a 2D drawing of the part, measuring its dimensions, and estimating the percentage of the surface area that will be in contact with the mold, it is possible to accurately calculate the projected area and use this information to determine the size and shape of the mold cavity and estimate the amount of lower flow materials that will be required for the injection molding process.